I don't know how to start this, but I think we are taking a step into the future. So, a couple of hours ago, Claude Sonnet 4.5 came out with a bunch of amazing products beside it. And I don't know really what to say. They have added a huge amount of value comparing to their competitors. So, in this video, I'm going to talk about Claude Sonnet 4.5, what is it, what are the new updates, and then how you can use each of these new products, where to use them, what are their benefits. So if you're ready, let's begin. So a couple of hours ago, Claude introduced Sonnet 4.5, and it's not just an upgrade for Claude, but beside that, they added different features and different products, which in a moment I will get to each one of them. So first of all, let's talk about Claude Sonnet 4.5. To access it, all you need to do is to just open your Claude, and here you can select Claude Sonnet 4.5, and you can start using it. So if you want to compare this update with the previous version of Sonnet 4, this version is of course much more intelligent comparing to the previous models in many areas, in agentic coding, in computer use, in high school math. As you can see, it is ranking higher comparing to the previous version or even to its competitors. And if we look at it in different fields like finance, law, medicine, and so on, in all of them, it is ranking much higher. But the important thing about this update is not just Sonnet 4.5 that it is much smarter. The other products beside it, the four main products that came with it, are the important thing here. So let's talk about each one of them. So first of all, if you use Sonnet 4.5 API, meaning, for example, you have a website or you have a plugin or you have an app that use Claude inside it, right? You can keep using it with the updated version, but with the same price, which it was $3 to $15 per million tokens, right? So they kept the price for API, which is amazing. And one interesting thing is that Claude Sonnet 4.5 can focus and run tasks for you for more than 30 hours straight, meaning you can set it, give it a complex, massive task, and go do your thing. Come back the next day, get your result. It's amazing. So let's talk about the four products that came with this update. The first one is Claude for Chrome extension. And the way it works is that you add the Claude extension to your Chrome, and then it gets access to your browser and it can complete tasks same as you do on your browser. For example, you can give it a task. Do this, gather this information, then arrange them into this Google Sheet, and then send a summary or email a summary to someone. Any task that you are doing yourself on Chrome, Claude extension can do as well for you. So here's an example done by Chrome. So in this scenario, the person is getting a message from a friend that how much budget do we have on the renovation, but you don't have all the information. You just have a file that it's not complete or it's not up to date. And the person asked Claude to complete this task. So if you look at this video, the Chrome extension, the Claude extension appears at the top. And here's the task. I don't have the complete budget. I just have a document with some planning and some numbers on it. And I want you to check my emails to see if I received a receipt from my contractor, and then arrange them all into a spreadsheet, and then draft a summary and email it to Jordan, right? So the Claude Chrome extension can do all this on its own. So it will analyze your file, the file that, for example, this person has on the pricing and budgets. It analyzes it, understands it, then it will ask for your permission if it is allowed to check your emails and search through the email to find the emails or receipts received from the contractor. right? Here it found some emails with some numbers on it, some costs, some receipts, right? It arranged all of them, gathered all the information in one place. Then it creates in a spreadsheet, or if you already have it, it will update the spreadsheet and then draft a summary and send the summary to the person that you want. Email it to the, it just prepare the email, write the title, write the email content, and it's ready for you to review it and click on send. And all of this is happening in seconds. So imagine if you want to do this on your own, by yourself, it would take several minutes to find all of the information, to search through the emails. Okay, here I have this information. Let's take it, put it here. Am I doing this right? You may make some mistakes along the way, but Claude Chrome extension can do it easily for you. Now, it's not available to public yet. It's on test version for now. And as soon as I get access to it, I will create another video for you on each of these new features, new products that Claude published recently. You can come here. I will put the link down in the description. If you are a Max user, or if you want to join the waitlist, you can come here, click on this button and join the waitlist and get access to this feature earlier. And here are some other examples. For example, add meeting rooms to existing events, or find emails that need responses. I have this problem. I have tons of emails that I can't even respond. Or, for example, find apartments matching these preferences. I'm looking for a three-bedroom house in Seattle under 800K with garage, and so on. So it can do all of these tasks for you. So don't forget to like the video if you are interested in this topic. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the future videos and trainings on each of these features. So let's talk about the next product, which is Claude Code. Now, Claude Code is not new. We had the previous version, version 1, which was amazing. And the way it works is that you can add Claude to Terminal or your coding editor. And while you're coding, Claude can help you, or Claude can edit your files, edit your code, make changes based on the prompt that he wrote, right? So now here we have Claude Code version 2, which is amazing. They have updated the interface. It's more understandable. It's easier, especially for people who are not a developer. They can use it much better. And it can work longer on more complex problems. And in a moment, I will show you. I have tested it. And I really feel happy about this. So they have a native VS Code extension, right? So I will put the link down in the description. You can come here, install it on your VS Code. And it looks like this. You have your project, you have your code, and here on the right side, this button appear, Claude. And you can start chatting with it. You can give tasks to it and it will complete the tasks for you. And it is much cleaner, more understandable and easier to work with. So just to show you how it is, here is a plugin that I made for Photoshop that it connects to AI models to generate images. And here I'm going to test to change the background of this image, and all of the every single part of this image was generated by AI models. And as you can see, the progress bar here at the bottom, it's not very complex. It's so simple, right? It is showing the status and the process of the image generation. But let's say I want to improve it. I want to develop it, right? I want something much better, especially if different models are active and we are generating different images at the same time. So I want to know that. So here, as you can see, it changed the color. And now I want to ask Claude to update this process, make it better. So I have gave the task, and as you can see, it creates a list of steps. And first, it will go through your files, understand your files, and then complete the task. So there are several major updates here that I really like. If you have been to my courses and my trainings before, every time that we are using an AI model to complete a massive task, to do something which is a little bit complex, what I always suggest is to divide that task into smaller parts, mini tasks, right? Why? Because when a task is complex, the AI just, AI model mix everything up, makes mistakes, and so on. But here, the good thing is that Claude Code do this on its own. If you look at here, it creates a list of steps that first I'm going to examine current process bar, right? Then I'm going to analyze how multiple AI models are handled in this code. Then I'm going to design an improved progress display. Then I'm going to implement it, change the code, right? Then I'm going to test it. And if there's a problem, I'm going to improve it. Now, before, the chance of Claude making mistakes in coding was around 9%. But now it is close to zero. And that's amazing. So this is one of the reasons that it is close to zero, because it will test the code that it wrote for you before completing the project. If it's not working, then it will update it itself, right? It will look at the errors, it will check it out. So here you can see the whole process. It went through all the files, read them, and as you can see, it just crossed the tasks that are completed. Now we are on this task, so let's design it. And here, for example, it changed the code, and the red part are the code that it removed, and the green part are the code that it added. And you can just click on it, examine it, go through it with it, right? For example, here we have a style.css. It went through it, right? It added all of these styles. And if we come down, now the design improved process is complete. Now let's implement it. It made some other changes in some other files. And if we come down here, it start to test this new update, right? It tests the update and it is successful. Perfect. Now let me mark the testing as complete. So it's completed, and by the end, you can see a very good looking and styled summary of what happened in details, right? For example, in this file, we have updated this part. In this file, we have added this, right? You can go through with it. So now let's see how our progress bar looks like. So I'm going to come here and make a selection. By the way, if you want to get access to this plugin to create cool images, to generate cool images, edit images inside Photoshop, work with layers, you can get the plugin down in the description. I will put the link for you as well. So here I'm going to select my image and write down, change the orange juice can to Coca-Cola, right? And orange juice splashes, change them to Coke. And also replace oranges on the air with lemons, right? And I have selected three models here, C-Dream4, Nano Banana, and Quinn2509. And let's look at the progress bar. So I'm just going to click on generate. And boom, as you can see, for each model, we have a separated progress bar that users can see and understand at which stage of processing they are right now. So we have C-Dream4 here. It is generating that. We have, it's complete. It's a Nano Banana now. It's starting. It's really good that we can see the status, and also we have the major progress bar here to understand the exact steps, or how long it remain till the end of this process, and it's ready. So I'm really happy about the style of the progress bar with just simple prompt. One simple prompt, it made all these changes, and I'm really happy about it. And as you can see, this is the result. We have lemon on the air, we have Coca-Cola can here, we have Coke here, and this image was generated by Quinn, right? Now we have Nano Banana version, and also we have C-Dream version, which C-Dream combined the can into glass, right? Into bottle glass. But anyway, that's why we have different models. Some of them are better at some tasks. For example, Quinn did a great job here. So this was a quick test of Claude Code. And later I will create a comprehensive video and training just on Claude Code, teach you how to install it, how to use it. And there are many other changes inside Claude Code, which later in that video, I'm going to talk more about it. So the next thing that we have here is Claude Agent SDK for developers. So for example, this Claude code that you saw, it's an agent, right? It will help us to complete tasks much easier. Now, they have prepared a great package for developers, and now developers can use this package, this SDK, to create agents, AI agents for different tasks. And these AI agents are much stronger comparing than before. They have better memory. They have checkpoints, right? They have checkpoints, so if they make a mistake, they can go back to the previous version and start from there, right? And restore your code. It's really amazing, and it's a great news for developers. The last product they published is amazing. It's a great idea. It is called Imagine with Claude. And the way it works is that it creates an environment like your computer, right? And there you can write your prompt. For example, you want a complete project, you want a complete app, you want a complete software, and you have no idea how to do it. And you just write the prompt, and Claude will start to create all the files, all the folders that is needed, and it will open the project for you. And you can test the project, work with the project or your software or your app while it is coding. So as you can see, it is just building, making the program, the software. And when you click on different areas, right, it will create the code for that area right at that moment. So it's a great way for people to generate, to create products, to create softwares. And this gives a great ability to people who are not developers, who have no idea how to create softwares, but they have good imagination, but they have great ideas. Now they can convert their ideas easily into a software, into a program, into an application, and they can sell it. It's like you have a team of developers, you just tell them what to do, and they will do it, right? Isn't that amazing? So this is not yet available.
Also, Imagine with Claude is not yet available to public, but if you have a Max account, you can use it. And soon I'm gonna create a much more complete video training on Imagine with Claude. So these were the new updates about Claude Sonnet 4.5. I hope you liked it. If you have any question or any request about Claude or the next trainings, the next videos that you want to see, write it down. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with your friends, because I think anyone who misses this update and the new features and the new tools, they are really missing out in the competition. And with one of these tools, you can change your career. You can make a huge difference, make a side project, start to make money with it, and have a better life, right? Why not? So that was all for this video. I hope to see you soon on the next one.